Shalom. All praise to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shah, Bahashem, Rukakodash. Double honor to the apostles and elders, a great millstone who rule well, who teach well, and a sincere salutation to the offering, pushing the truth throughout the four winds of the earth, waking up the hope for the elect. Coming at you one more time with another little video about a damsel and her flower. Okay, the mysteries of these Bibles, man. It's mysteries. This Bible is a mystery, man. It ain't for everybody. Okay? It's in parables, riddles, codes, man. Mysteries. And everybody can't get this. Which brought this to my attention, really, about this this virgin. Okay, this young damsel, a young woman, man. Okay? This rape doctrine. That you fools can't seem to let it come into your head, man. That how things was in the ancient time, man. How it's supposed to be. How it really is. Okay? About a damsel and her flower, man. Everybody caught up with the rape doctrine, man. If you can't receive this, man, this ain't for you, man. Okay? Just like most you can't receive the reincarnation. Okay, doctrine. But that's another chapter, man. But basically the same thing, because you can't receive that either, man. That John was Elijah was forth to come, man. Now, they got different verses about a damsel, okay? If a man take hold of a young damsel or a virgin, man, and lay hold on her or rape her. Okay, now I'm gonna read these. These is different translations and different Bibles, man, through the times. Now this first one I'm going into, this is the New International Version. And it reads, this Deuteronomy 22 and 28. Okay, you read it yourself. Deuteronomy 22 and 28. Now these are all different versions that they wrote, okay, in different Bibles, different translations. And it reads, it's the first one, a New International Version. If a man happens to meet a virgin who is not pledged to be married and rapes her, and they are discovered. Now you can read the rest of that in Deuteronomy 22 and 28. But I'm trying to get y'all to understand, man. Okay? It's the same meaning, man. New International Version. If a man happens to meet a virgin who is not pledged to be married and rapes her, and they are discovered. Now this is the New Living Translation. Suppose a man has intercourse with a young woman who is a virgin, but she is not engaged to be married if they are discovered. Now this is the English Standard Version. It reads, if a man meets a virgin who is not betrothed and seizes her and lies with her, and they are found. Now this is the New American Standard Bible. If a man finds a girl who is a virgin, who is not engaged, and seizes her and lays with her, and they are discovered. This is the King James Bible. If a man finds a damsel that is a virgin, which is not betrothed, and lay hold on her, which means rape her. He took her, man. Rape just means take, man. Okay? And lay hold on her and lie with her, and they are found. Now this is the Holman Christian Standard Bible. If a man encounters a young woman, a virgin, who is not engaged, takes hold of her and rapes her, and they are discovered. Okay? It's the same thing, man. Rapes. If he rapes her or lay hold on her, man, it's the same thing, man. Okay? This is the International Standard Version. However, if a man meets a girl who isn't engaged to be married, and he seizes her, rapes her, and is later found out. You people can't, you won't get this in your head, man. This is in the scriptures, man. This is the NET Bible. Suppose a man come across a virgin who is not engaged and overpowers and rapes her, and they are discovered. Okay, this is the New Hard English Bible. If a man finds a lady who is a virgin, who is not pledged to be married, and lay hold on her, and lie with her, and they be found. What you fools can't get this, man? Why you can't get this through your head, man? It's the same thing, man. This is God's word translation. This is what you must do when a man rapes a virgin who is engaged, who isn't engaged, when the crime is discovered. This is the JPS Tanakh 1917. If a man finds a damsel that is a virgin that is not betrothed, and lay hold on her and lie with her, and they be found. This is the New American Standard 1977. If a man finds a girl who is a virgin, who is not engaged, and seizes her and lies with her, and they are discovered. Now this is the Jubilee Bible 2000. When a man finds a damsel that is a virgin, who is not betrothed, and lays hold on her, and lies with her, and they are found. This is the King James 2000 Bible. If a man finds a young woman that is a virgin, who is not betrothed, and lay hold on her, and lie with her, and they be found. This is the American King James Version. If a man finds a damsel that is a virgin, which is not betrothed, and lay hold on her, and lie with her, and they be found. American Standard Version. If a man finds a damsel that is a virgin, that is not betrothed, and lay hold on her, and lie with her, and they be found. Okay? And it keep going on, man. And it keep going, you got the Darby Bible translation. If a man finds a damsel, a virgin, who is not betrothed, and lay hold on her, and lie with her, and they be found. Okay, this is the Webster Bible translation. If a man shall find a damsel that is a virgin, who is not betrothed, and lay hold on her, and lie with her, and they be found. Okay, and it keep going on and on, man. I don't understand what you don't get about this, man. And it tells you simple and plain, man. If a man happens to meet a virgin who is not pledged to be married and rapes her, and they are discovered. What's so hard about that, man? What you don't understand about that? I don't understand. Now this is 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 36. Because y'all going through all the extra, man. And this is some old, man, that the apostles of GMS, man, brought out years ago, man, that y'all can't seem to get around, man. But it's a stumbling block to you fools, man. It's a stumbling block to you idiots, man. To you stupidity ones out there, man. This 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 36. But if any man think that he behaving himself uncomely towards his virgin, if she pass the flower of her age, and need so require, let him do what he will. He sinneth not. Let them marry. Did you hear what I just read? 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 36. But if any man think that he behaving himself uncomely towards his virgin, if she pass the flower of her age, when does a woman get her flower, which is her period? Normally, it's between 12 and 14, right? So, in ancient time, if she got to her flower, man, and need so require, okay? Let him do what he will. Let the man do what he will, man. Okay? Let them marry. Marriage is me have sex, man. Okay? That's all marry mean, man. To have sex, man. Okay? Take hold of her. Rape her. However you want to put it, man. It's the same thing, man. Ain't nobody raping no women, man. This is in the scriptures, man. It's not now man a GMS that has raped a woman, man. The apostles just trying to get you dummies to understand, man. This is in the scriptures, man. This is of the ancient time, man. This is biblical, man. You had to have a young woman, man. One of old women popping off like that, man. It was a young woman, man. You had to be fruitful with a young woman, man, and have kids, man. This is scripture, man. Okay? Let me read this one more time for you fools, man. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 36. But if any man think that he behaved himself uncomely towards his virgin. Now, this is Paul, man. Okay? He said, verse 36, 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 36. Read it yourself. But if any man think that he behaving himself uncomely towards his virgin, if she pass the flower of her age, and need so require, let him do what he will. Take it. Lay hands on, lay hold of her, or rape her. Okay? All it means is just take by force, man. That's all it means. But Esau, who done got into y'all heads, man, rape is raping a woman, man. Ain't nobody raping no women, man. Ain't nobody raping no women, man. Y'all can't name none account of a GMS, man. Apostle, elder, okay, young disciple, raping no women, man. But y'all always want to bring that out, man. That's because you don't know the scriptures, man. And this is biblical, man. It's in the scriptures, man. Read your book, man. Read this again. 1 Corinthians 7, verse 36. But if any man think that he behaved himself uncomely towards his virgin, if she pass the flower of her age and need so require, let him do what he will. He sinneth not. Let them marry, man. Let them have sex, man. Okay? If she have a period, man, that means she's a grown woman, man. Okay? That means she's a full developed woman. And the Most High Yahweh is commanded so, man, for it to be done, man. Okay? The Most High gave authority, man. So who are you to say that it's rape, man? Rape just means take hold of, man. That's all it means, man. Take hold of them, man. That's what rape means, man. But you don't let Esau condemn your mind, man. But he was raping our women back in slavery time, man. Taking a young girl, 12 and 13, after they had their flower, man. Okay? And it's known, man. And you can look that up in history. It's known for them to have a young woman in the house, let her marinate for a while. Then when they was 13, 14, when they had their period, man. Someone had it at 12, man. Esau was popping the women. But he changed the law, man. Okay? And that's in Isaiah 24, man. He changed the laws, man. Why? So his young women couldn't get popped like that, man. From Jake. Jake would have been popping them young women. Them young white girls, man. Okay? You people out there are wicked, man. Ain't nobody raping nobody, man. The scriptures say, man, if she pass her flower, man, and need so require, man. Okay? He sin not, man. You fools out there, man. Y'all wicked, man. But guess what? The time coming, man. Because y'all love Esau. Y'all love the Edomites, man. Them so-called white people, man. Y'all love them red devils, man. I'm going to run this back for you lames, man. This is Deuteronomy 22, verse 28, man. If a man happens to meet a virgin who is not pledged to be married and rapes her, and they are discovered. This is the King James Bible version. If a man finds a damsel that is a virgin which is not betrothed and lay hold on her and lie with her and they be found. Okay? If you rape her or lay hold on her, it's the same thing, man. It's the same thing, man. One more time, man, for edification. 1 Corinthians 7:36, man. But if any man think that he behaved himself uncomely towards his virgin, if she pass the flower of her age and need so require, let him do what he will. He sinneth not, let them marry. You can't get around that, man. The truth is the truth, man. If you read your scriptures, you will know this. Okay? You will know this. So for all you that don't understand the scriptures, hey man, stay out the faces of the men that got the truth, man, in GMS, man, at the camps. Stay out the faces of the truth, man. Won't you run to all the other camps, man, with that lame mess, man? You keep coming up, barking up against the truth for the Most High Yahweh. And his son Yahweh Shah, man, through the men that he set up, man, a great millstone, man. The apostles and the elders, man, all the way down to the little young disciples, man, they got this truth, man. Okay? Y'all ain't running to no other camps, man. No other camp. Y'all keep running up to the men of GMS, man. But guess what? That's just more edification for the camera, man. For all the YouTubers out there in YouTube land, man, that's watching. Edification is great, man. But you don't know the scripture, man. Your Christianity is being destroyed, man. Day by day, man. Camp by camp. It's being destroyed, man. And the Most High said, Yahweh Shah said, when this word get pushed throughout the whole earth, then the end shall come. Now, Christianity been pushed over the whole planet, man, back and forth thousands of times, man, over centuries of time. Why haven't the end came yet? He said, when the four corners of the earth know his name, then the end shall come. Why haven't the end came yet, man? Because Christianity is not the truth, man. That is a tradition of a man, okay? Set up through Constantine and other jakes back in the centuries, man, to keep you massive deceived, man. Following all this madness, Christmas and Halloween and all the other pagan holidays, man. The truth. That the Most High name is Yahweh, his son name Yahweh Shah, okay? Rekah Kodash, man, the Holy Spirit, man. And you dummies, man, you Christianities, you Christians, man, that's pushing the Christianity, man, that's not the truth, man, because that's been over the whole planet, man. That ain't the truth, man. And the whole truth for the matter is, man, you don't believe in this truth, man. Okay? You are of your father, the devil, man. Satan. Okay? You are the seeds of Satan, man. point blank period. But with that, I hope someone out there will edify, man, in YouTube land. I'll pray to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, double honor to the apostle and elders, a great millstone, man, and a sincere salutation to the ark and pushing the truth throughout the four winds of the earth. Shalom.